Welcome to 5 News Online. I'm Joe Ellison. Now, Fayetteville is preparing to host country music legend Garth Brooks this weekend. If you're going, there's lots you need to know. Even if you didn't grab a ticket for this, you'll still be impacted by traffic. Now, Garth Brooks is playing Saturday at Razorback Stadium. The show was originally sold out, but the university has opened up additional seating in the Capitol Club and Diamond Club. Those tickets are priced at $94.95. But they are sure to sell out fast. Now, Fayetteville Police posted a few maps on its Facebook page to see the directions you'll need to take to get to your parking lot and where you can be let off if you're using Uber or Lyft. Now, you can view all those details on the Fayetteville Police Department's Facebook page. And when it comes to COVID, the university says masks are recommended in indoor areas and required on all shuttles. But proof of vaccination is not required to get in. All right, let's get a quick check of that weather with meteorologist Zach Scott. Hey, Zach.
Hey, Joe, we are looking at a warm day here. Clouds are breaking, sunshine's mixing in on your Thursday. Temperatures are rising, upper 70s, lower 80s for highs for your Thursday. Another mild night, breezy south winds about 5 to 15 miles per hour, keeping those temperatures in the lower 60s. And then more sunshine expected on your Friday. Going to boost those temperatures into the 80s, pretty much area-wide. We are tracking a chance for thunderstorms coming in on Sunday, so make sure you keep checking back as we'll get you updated as we get closer.
Thanks so much, Zach. Well, the city of Fayetteville has replaced all 250 coin-operated parking meters in downtown. They're now using smart meters. They accept cash, coins, cards, and virtual money, like from Apple Pay. But with this change comes some extra cost when it comes to paying per hour. The old meters cost 50 cents for 2 hours. Now you can expect to pay $1 for those 2 hours. Now in the next week, you can expect to see an app called Park Mobile available. That app will help you find open parking spots around the downtown area. And today is United Way of Fort Smith's annual Day of Caring, where over 700 volunteers will serve nonprofit agencies and organizations in the River Valley. Volunteers will help with things like yard work, power washing, cooking, painting, and more. Now, this morning, volunteers met at a few different spots around the River Valley to eat breakfast together before heading out to serve their communities.
It's just great to see everybody being able to come out, rally as one, whether it be one day a year, whether it be multiple days a year. But on this day particularly, it's so great to see so many come out and kind of put everything else aside and come together as one to serve our River Valley community here.
And some from our 5 News team made their way out to help with projects today. Just to name a few, 5 News anchor Darren Bobb, executive producer Brittany Boyette, and reporter Ian Taylor put in some hard work today. Now, tomorrow is the United Way of NWA's annual Day of Caring. Volunteers will head out in the morning to help their neighbors. Well, for more of the latest weather and news, catch up with us again tomorrow right here at 5 News Online. I'm Joe Ellison. Have a great day.